subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is known around the world for its history, cultural heritage, and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Yeshi Chonsom, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India is a country with vibrant culture and a colorful way of life, where a number of festivals are celebrated throughout the year. These festivals are an important part of the country's cultural inheritance and showcase the deep association that Indians share with their roots. So this week in our episode of My India, we will take you to one such revered pilgrimage site in India, Jagannath Puri, where devotees witnessed the auspicious Puri Goshani Yatra, which was the cultural highlight last week amid the coronavirus pandemic. Singing and dancing on the heady beats of drums, devotees gathered in front of famous Jagannath temple to celebrate the fascinating festival of Goshani Jatra with great zeal and fervor. The festival has its origin in the folk culture of Puri. Grand procession carrying clay idols of goddess Durga, closely watching or fighting with the demon Mahishasur, passes through the streets of the city. Every year, this yatra is celebrated with great enthusiasm. However, this year due to coronavirus pandemic, the procession was carried out under the strict watch of the police and the authorities.
2 lakh se zyada hota tha har saal, lekin is saal covid ka baare mein procession aise prachar kiya, aadmi log aa nahi paya, ghar mein bhi darshan kar nahi paya aur bahut subah subah maa ko leke pahunch gaya mandir mein.
Goshani Yatra also holds its association with the festival of Durga Puja, which coincides with the festival. But unlike most places where Durga Puja is celebrated, the tales related to Goshani Yatra are different. The word Goshani means the Shaktis that were fighting alongside goddess Durga in her fight with Mahishasur. The idols of the goddess Durga are therefore different, and they depict Mahisha Mardini Durga, that is goddess Durga killing the demon Mahishasur. Therefore, during the time of Durga Puja, citizens of Puri use Goshani images during their Durga Puja procession in their respective streets. The festival is also a way to tribute Lord Jagannath. After completion of all the religious prayers and rituals followed by the grand procession, these idols of goddess Durga are immersed in a river or the sea.
Kalahandi ke adhishtatri devi maa Manikeshwari ka aaj vishwa prasidh chhatar jatra hai aur hajar barso se ye parampara chalti aa rahi hai aur is saal कोविड के लिए आज देखिए लोगों का समागम नहीं हो पाया. प्रशासन का बहुत सारे गाइडलाइंस था, उसको पालन किया गया है.
Goshani Yatra is prime and prominent festival for Odias. And according to the Hindu calendar, this yatra is celebrated in the month of Ashwin. India is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. The unity of these myriad faiths can be very well witnessed at the dargahs of Sufi saints. Today, we take you to one such dargah of Hazrat Sayyid Afzaluddin Abu Jafar in Uttar Pradesh that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities. Have a look.
An epicenter of faiths, a place where brotherhood and bohemy between many religions have flourished and prospered. The dargah of Hazrat Sayyid Afzaluddin Amir Mah, situated in a small town in Uttar Pradesh, is one such melange of diversities. Situated in Baharaich district, the shrine witnesses a rush of devotees throughout the day. Whether one is a Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, or from any other community, devotees come here to offer their prayers to the Sufi saint who propagated the messages of righteousness and truthfulness.
यहाँ कोई भेदभाव नहीं है. अल्लाह के वलियों को यहाँ वो सिर्फ इंसान समझ के और मजबूर समझ के कमजोर समझ के अपना समझ के सबको सब पे दया करते हैं, सब पे कर्म करते हैं और सबको निभाते हैं. अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह यहाँ कोई भेदभाव नहीं है कि हिंदू है या मुसलमान है तो मुसलमान को करीब किया जाए, हिंदू भाई को दूर किया जाए, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. बल्कि जो भी आता है उसको अपने दामन मोहब्बत में जगह देते हैं, अपने फैज़ से नवाजते हैं. अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह
It is believed that Sayyid Afzaluddin is the seventh generation of Imam Hussain, who was the grandson of Prophet Muhammad. Devotees believe that the saint died around 670 years ago in the year 1350 AD. Ever since, devotees have been visiting this dargah in order to seek the blessings of the revered saint. It is believed that the Sufi saint fulfills the wishes of all and nobody returns empty-handed from here. The dargah also observes Urs annually when people from different religious communities throng the dargah to seek his blessings. The shrine showcases religious tolerance by drawing people from different faiths who leave aside their differences and pray for peace and harmony.
जैसे हम लोग मंदिर में जाते हैं वैसे यहाँ दरगाह में भी जाते हैं. जिस तरह हम लोग अपने देवी देवता शंकर ब्रह्मा विष्णु महेश को पूछते हैं उस तरह हम यहाँ आके दरगाह शरीफ में बड़े पुरुष गाजी मियाँ सबको उसी नज़रिए से देखते हैं. हमारे लिए सभी धर्म एक बराबर हैं, चाहे वो मुस्लिम धर्म में हो या फिर चर्च में जाए या ईसाई में जाए या मस्जिद में आए, हमारे लिए सभी देवता एक समान.
The dargah of Hazrat Sayyid Afzaluddin Amir Mah is a perfect example of communal harmony that is witnessed throughout the length and breadth of our country. The solidarity among the different religious communities has remained a hallmark of India's unity since time immemorial.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated and took the first flight of the country's maiden seaplane in his home state of Gujarat. The 19-seater seaplane operated by Indian budget airline SpiceJet Spice Shuttle will connect Ahmedabad and Kevadia cities of the state, reducing the 4-hour travel time by road to 45 minutes.
यहाँ से साबरमती 40 मिनट में लोग पहुँच जाएंगे और एक बिल्कुल एक फ़र्क अनुभव लोगों को होगा. एक यूनिक मैं कहूँगा एक्सपीरियंस जो लोग सी प्लेन में कभी भी नहीं गए हैं उनके लिए एक बहुत यूनिक एक्सपीरियंस रहेगा। सी प्लेन एक लो हाइट पे फ्लाई करता है, चारों तरफ जो यहाँ का सौंदर्य है उसको देखना आसान होगा और स्टैचू के भी पास सी प्लेन जाएगा।
The plane will cover a distance of 200 kilometers between the two cities and will reportedly cost around 1500 rupees per person for a one-side journey. The seaplane service will also ease the connectivity to the world's tallest statue, Statue of Unity, colossal statue of Indian independence hero Vallabhbhai Patel.
Devotees in India's northern Amritsar city offered prayers at Sikhism's holiest shrine, the Golden Temple, to mark the birth anniversary of a revered spiritual leader, the fourth Sikh Guru Ram Das. Sikhs thronged the temple in the evening as they marked the occasion with lighting earthen oil lamps and then later enjoyed fireworks.
बहुत अच्छा लगा है, हर साल आते हैं, देश विदेश से संगत आती है, जहाँ पर जो भी संगत आती है खुशी के लिए अरदास करती है, अपने घर परिवार के लिए अरदास करती है। वैसे ही संगत अपने जो वर्ल्ड में महामारी फैली है कोविड-19 की, उसके लिए भी अरदास करती है कि जल्द से जल्द ये बीमारी ठीक हो और दुनिया वैसे ही जल्द से जल्द अपने काम काज पर लग जाए।
The Sikh fraternity reveres the event since it marks the birth anniversary of their fourth guru, who is said to have been born in 1534. He is also known to be the founder of holiest city of Sikhism, Amritsar.
An Indian welfare group is making environment-friendly idols of Hindu gods with cow dung ahead of the festive season in northern Punjab state. Gauri Shankar Seva Dal, the animal welfare group led by Ramesh Sharma, takes care of nearly 2,000 cows in Chandigarh and Mohali districts in various shelters. During the COVID-19 situation and its subsequent economic impact, the organization was not getting enough funds and donations.
पानी के साथ ये खाद का काम करेगी। एक तो कुछ समय में ही इसका विसर्जन हो जाएगा और एक अच्छे रूप में विसर्जन होगा, जिसमें पौधे को खाद भी मिलेगी और वो पौधा अपने आप में आगे बढ़ेगा भी। उस लक्ष्य को लेकर हमने ये मूर्तियाँ बनाई हैं ताकि मूर्तियों का भी सम्मान रहे और जितने भी वातावरण ये जो पेड़ पौधे हैं इनको भी खाद मिलती रहे।
Cows are considered sacred in Hinduism, equivalent to God and are worshipped. Even from the environmental perspective, cow dung is known to be fine organic manure for almost all kinds of plants without any side effects. However, the organization is still not selling the idols and other items they make from the cow dung, and all those who visit the shelter can just take it with them.
India, the United States, Japan and Australia began their largest joint naval exercises in over a decade. The annual Malabar War Games that India holds with the United States and Japan have been expanded to include Australia this year to cover all members of the Quad, an informal group of the four largest democracies in the Indo-Pacific. China has accused the United States, which has been leading the effort to forge a common front among its allies, of a Cold War mentality and ideological prejudice. Five ships of the Indian Navy, including a submarine, were deployed in the exercise, along with US Navy's John S. McLean missile destroyer, Australia's Ballarat frigate, and a Japanese destroyer, the Indian Ministry of Defence said. There will be no contact between the military personnel of the four nations because of the COVID-19 restrictions during the first phase of the drills running till November 6, it said. The exercise comes at a time when the host India is locked in a military standoff on the disputed land border with China. Diversity is India's hallmark. People from different religious and cultural backgrounds not only reside here amicably but also play an integral part in each other's festivities. Book worship or Chopda Pujan is an important ritual performed during the Hindu festival of Diwali and is celebrated in different forms around the country. Muslims in Ahmedabad city of Gujarat have been contributing their bit to this Hindu ritual by making red account books which are worshipped on the occasion, thereby delivering the message of unity and brotherhood. Have a look.
Diwali is a festival that not only adds up lights, colors and happiness to our lives, but also brings together citizens of different communities, creed, caste and religions as they get a chance to forget their differences and celebrate the happy festival together. Said to be the most appropriate time for seeking the blessings of Goddess Lakshmi, Lord Ganesh and Goddess Saraswati, the holy deities that are worshipped on the occasion, a number of different rituals are performed to offer prayers to the gods during the festival. One such ritual is Chopda Puja, wherein new account books or Bahi Khata are sanctified and worshipped to seek the blessings of Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth. In Ahmedabad district of Gujarat, Muslims have been making these red books for a number of years as a mark of the communal bond shared by both the communities.
ज़्यादातर हमारा ये books और चौपड़े का जो business है और उसको बनाने का काम है जो मुस्लिम लोग करते हैं और बरसों से आज 150 वर्षों 200 साल से मुस्लिम परिवार लोग जो है वो चौपड़ा हमारे यहाँ बनाते हैं और वो हमको देते हैं और कारीगर भी हमारे यहाँ मुस्लिम ही होते हैं क्योंकि ये चौपड़ा बनाने का मुस्लिम का ही होता है तो हमारे यहाँ हिंदू मुस्लिम की एक इखलासता है एक सद्भावना है और मुस्लिम लोग ये नहीं सोचते कि हम बनाते और हिंदू लोग ही चौपड़ा लिखते तो गुजरात में बरसों से मुस्लिम कारीगर जो हमारे यहाँ चौपड़ा बनाते और हम हिंदू लोग उनको चौपड़ा लिखते हैं
Situated in Kagri Bazaar area of Ahmedabad, Ahmed Bhai, like many other Muslims, has been making these red account books for years. These red books are further worshipped by many Gujarati entrepreneurs and businessmen who perform the auspicious ceremony. Ahmed prays to God that all his Gujarati brothers, be it Hindus or Muslims or of any other religion, prosper in their businesses as well as in life.
मुस्लिम परिवार से हूँ मैं और गुजराती भाइयों को बना के देता हूँ व्यापारियों को व्यापारी उनको देते हैं और वो लोग ले जाके इसकी पूजा पाठ करके वो लोग लिखते हैं नए साल में और नए साल में अच्छे से अच्छा जाए अगला साल तो बेकार गया और ये नया साल में नई नई उमंग आ जाओ नया ये हो जाओ सबके धंधे व्यापार में रोजगार में खड़े बरकत अता फरमा अल्लाह ताला
Chopda Pujan is usually performed on the full moon day of Shukla Paksha in the Hindu almanac of Ashwin, which coincides with the Gregorian month of October-November. Examples like these are witnessed in every nook and corner of the country, and it has become quite common to see people from different religious and cultural backgrounds coming together and making these occasions a happy and a successful one.
The land of Jammu and Kashmir is not only famous for its picturesque views, but also for its handicrafts, which speaks volumes about the artistic expertise of Kashmiri craftsmen. The administration of Jammu and Kashmir has been extending all kinds of support to local artisans in order to promote their artworks and pace up their sales amid the pandemic. In the same line of initiatives taken by the authorities to promote Kashmiri handicrafts, a handloom and handicrafts exhibition was recently organized at Kashmir Haat in Srinagar. Let's take a look. Kashmir is famous for its traditional handicrafts, attires, shawls and more. Kashmiri handicrafts not only showcase the tremendous creativity and potential of Kashmiri artisans, but also play a major role in contributing to the mainstream economic activities of the region. Special exhibitions are organized at regular intervals to sell these handicraft items. But this year, amid the worldwide pandemic, all economic activities came to halt. Now, as the country is returning back to normal, authorities in Jammu and Kashmir organize a handicrafts exhibition to promote the handicrafts.
हम शुक्रगुजार हैं यहाँ हैंडीक्राफ्ट डिपार्टमेंट के कि उन्होंने कोविड में ये सब किया हुआ है तो बहुत अच्छा लगा ये देख के कि हम यहाँ पे शॉपिंग कर पाए तो शायद हमने ये सोचा था दोबारा हम नहीं देख सकेंगे ये तो थैंक यू सो मच हैंडीक्राफ्ट डिपार्टमेंट
The exhibition comes sale aimed at providing a platform to local artisans in order to help them in promoting their items along with earning good returns for their sales. From beautiful pashmina and kani shawls to silk carpets and paper machine products, a wide variety of things were at display in the exhibition. While the visitors were happy to attend an exhibition after a long time, the administration ensured complete adherence to the social distancing norms amid the ongoing pandemic.
हमने यहाँ पर पेपर माशी रखी है और कश्मीर हैंडीक्राफ्ट रखा है शॉल रखे हैं सूट रखे हैं तो बहुत सारी वैरायटी रखी हमने
मैं पहली बार आया हूँ इस कश्मीर हाट में मैंने यहाँ पे जो एग्जीबिशन देखा है मुझे बहुत ही अच्छा लगा बहुत यूनिक है यहाँ पे कश्मीर के जो आइटम्स है हर कोई कश्मीर का यूनिक आइटम यहाँ पे दस्तियाब है और वो भी रीजनेबल रेट्स में
The exhibition had been organized under the Union Government's initiative of Local Save Vocal, which was launched for promoting local indigenous products. Along with providing direct market exposure to the craftsmen and artisans, the administration also brought them opportunities to sell their products at various e-commerce sites.
मार्केट लिंकेज अगर है एक अच्छा इनिशिएटिव भी है कि फ्लिपकार्ट के साथ अभी दे हैव जॉइंट हैंड्स के इनके जो प्रोडक्ट्स हैं वो ऑनलाइन अवेलेबल रहें लेकिन जैसे वो वोकल फॉर लोकल की हम बात करते हैं कि लोकल आर्टिसंस को लोकल प्रोडक्शन को सपोर्ट करना चाहिए तो मुझे यकीन है कि लोकल लोगों की सपोर्ट के साथ जो हमारे आर्टिसंस हैं उनको काफ़ी बेनिफिट मिलेगा
एग्जीबिशंस लाइक दिस डेमोंस्ट्रेट द ब्यूटी एंड कल्चरल रिचनेस ऑफ वेरियस स्टेट्स ऑफ इंडिया Local artists and craftsmen use it as an opportunity to expand their business and make their products available at all corners of the country. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Yeshi Chonsom and it's goodbye from the entire production team.